Matuvu, o halaka o Yaakov, va mishkenoteka o Israel. How beautiful are your tents, O Yaakov, and your dwelling place, or your tabernacle, O Israel. Hi, this is Barry Phillips of 10 Minute Torah, day number one of the Torah portion, Balak. Very interesting Torah portion in that we encounter the leadership of the Moabites, who are relatives of Israel, who are facing warfare against their cousins, and the depths of spiritual warfare that have to be engaged in order to set this battle in array. I'm Israel, the people of Israel, this covenant group of people who, many of which live in the land of Israel currently as of the house of Yehuda, our brother the Jews, but even more so scattered throughout the nations of the earth is the house of Israel, most of which, the larger portion of which, have no clue as to who they are or what their vital connection to the covenant of Yah really is. Many sit on church pews, faithful to go to church every Sunday, to be involved in their local congregations, good, righteous people who follow the Messiah to the best of their knowledge and understanding. They give, they worship, they sing, they celebrate, and they live good, upstanding, scriptural lives. Again, to the best of their understanding. It's what we all do. But they have no clue how many of them, because of their adoption into the covenant through Yeshua the Messiah, they have no idea their vital connection to Am Israel. In many of those situations, it's simply understood, well, Israel is the Jews. The Jews make up a very significant and very important part of the family of Israel. But again, many of us have been scattered and have no clue to our identity. There's a key word, identity. We don't know who we are. And even in the Hebraic roots movement, community, whatever collective term that you want to use to describe this body, there is a lack of real identity. It's as easy for many of us to get caught up in the keeping of feast days and Shabbat and doing what we do, whether or not we wear a kippah, how we tie our tzitzit and wear them on our clothing, how we pronounce the Creator's name, and on the list goes. We get so caught up in all of these things that sometimes we forget, wait a minute, beyond all of these things that are important and they do have their place, is the realization that I'm part of a collective, a family, a mishpachah. Family is extremely important for those families that know how to function together, that are loving, encouraging, mutually benefiting. Nothing is sweeter on the face of the earth. Many folks, unfortunately, family means a place or a group of people you get together with to fight, to be disgruntled at, to be chafed at the actions of. Sibling rivalries that were experienced in childhood have never been resolved and grown beyond. Parent-child relationships are strained, if they exist at all, and it's problematic. Grandchildren have issues, on and on. Family oftentimes means the bunch that squabble and fight together. When it comes to Moab, descendants of Lot and one of his daughters, Moab meaning from father, this daughter did not try to hide the identity of her son very well. The Moabites now live in an area just outside of Eretz Israel, This is future territory. This is territory that will be a part of the coming kingdom. But because Moab refused to allow Am Israel entrance to come through the country, then war had to ensue. Balak, the leader that we encounter in Bamidbar chapter number 22, verse 2, and Balak, son of Zippor, saw all that Israel had done to the Amorites, and Moab was exceedingly afraid of the people because of their number. They were many, and Moab was in dread because of the children of Israel. They were in dread. They were in fear because of the military might and strength in their numbers, but they were in dread because of their identity. Think about that. In our day, one could be fearful of a lot of different things. Unfortunately, violence has been unfurled here in America, in our streets. Buildings burn. Our law enforcement has been degraded publicly and defunded in many places. We have mistrust in government again. Things don't look well and positive in many respects. People are fearful. What do? You cling to your identity. You determine who you are. Wherever you are and however you are, Yah is the one who is given to us this identity, and it's based on covenant. Balak, the destroyer, the waster, is what his name means. He represents the spiritual elements of darkness that war against those who carry the covenant and the name of the Mashiach. In Revelation chapter 12, we've talked about this many times, the mouth of the dragon is opened up and a river of propaganda and words come out of his mouth. And we're hearing those words even now. If you listen in social media or television media, radio, you're going to hear the propaganda. You're going to hear the words of division and hate and spite and anti-Semitism. Make no bones about it, no mistake about it. The vicious words that are hurled against those who live in the land and Jews who live in the United States that are now coming under attack. That same spirit of anti-Semitism, when it attacks our brother Yehuda, you're in the line of fire as well because we carry the same covenant. We're a part of the same covenant family. What does this mean? It means that you and I need to be engaged in the war, in the battle. We're not talking about with weapons of man's warfare. I'm talking about learning to pray powerfully. Balaam is going to be hired, and we'll talk more about him through the week, to use sorcery gifts, dark arts, false prophecy, false words, soothsaying, charms, talismans, and enchantments in order to produce a spiritual arena that will bring in an advantage over those that Yah has so identified and named. And one might boldly say, well, I'm born again, so therefore none of those things have any effect on me. Don't be so glib and don't be so nonchalant about things. When witchcraft is operating, when dark arts are being manipulated, when demonic forces are being summoned, the believer knows it. You may be born again, you may be spirit-filled, you may pray in tongues, you may have gifts that you operate in, but be very understanding. These things will have, to some degree, an effect because there's more than just saying the blood's there and it's done. The blood of Messiah is powerful and effective, And yes, we win in Yeshua, but there's more going on than what meets the eye. And it's the more than what we naturally see that we want to talk about this week. Pray. Pray hard. And I'll see you tomorrow. Until then, shalom.